Hey YouTube, I thought I'd do a quick video on my DX Commander. End of the year last year, I bought a DX Commander. Before that, I had a dipole. Get you a picture of it there if I can. It's sitting in the backyard on the ground. And if you can see how it's staked out, very little guying on it, and we've had some pretty good wind storms. It's pretty amazing. I guess it just doesn't have a whole lot of wind load on it. The whole antenna, I'm not joking, is 3 pounds. Went to bed together really well. Can show you my QRZ log, what I've been doing off of FT8 with it. It's pretty good. Let me see if I can move it around a little bit more. There's some other calls that I've made. We got my signal report and all those, so doing pretty well on it. I've got a couple that's not confirmed pulling, but I got signal reports on there, and they'll come in. So that being said, I think it's a great antenna. When I bought it, I could not find, you know, too much on YouTube about, hey, is it okay to be in trees? How far does it, can it be from your house? This is about 30 feet from my house. I'm doing really well. Let me show you my waterfall here. So here's my waterfall. That's 40 meters. Let me throw it to 20 meters there. So see this, these lines coming in here? That's my wireless dog fence or invisible fence. Let me see if I can get down. Do 21. See the noise background is nothing. Why do I keep doing that? There's some signals there. Looks pretty good. So like I said, the noise floor on it is amazing. I guess Augie had some problems putting it together. I didn't. I think on his video, one of the things was that he was using guys that hadn't passed a general exam, didn't really know about antenna links, really wasn't familiar with that, with antennas. I think Callum, when he wrote the original directions, he figured that people would know, you know, a little bit about antennas because they've passed their general or whatever type of general knowledge that they have to have in over there in England. But I didn't have any problem in it. It was pretty fun. Put it together in a couple of hours. Let me see here. See what I can find on his YouTube channel. He's got a new video. And it goes into really good detail on how to build his antenna. You can go to videos here, and this latest and greatest one shows his video and how to put it together. So if you can find that, I think that's probably a $300 antenna. I can't remember, but it's well worth it. Like I said, it's easy to put together, doesn't take any space. The wind load on it is nothing. It's literally 3 pounds. When you pick that antenna up, it's crazy how light it is. I've been through some pretty good wind storms out here, knocked some trees down. That stood, and that guying that's on there is hardly anything. So just want to let you know, if you're looking for an antenna, a small space, the DX Commander for what the price is, what the sound, you saw what I did on QRZ on FT8, the the floor on it, how good that is. You can't go wrong. If you get a chance, go look at the DX Commander. Look at the reviews. I don't think you'll be dissatisfied with it. When I first started being in a ham, that was my big concern. It's money to put out there. You've got a good radio. You want a good antenna. Just letting you know, if you go with the DX Commander, you can't go wrong. Thanks, YouTube. Hit that like and subscribe. I'd appreciate it.